Have you ever felt like you were in the zone when the world around you just fades away and your ideas just keeps flowing? That special moment when you lose track of time, hours pass by, and the ideas just kept flowing again and again. In design, we call this state flow. It is the heartbeat of creativity. But what happens when flow is disrupted? Something just doesn't work. You pause, you get frustrated, and you feel the flow slipping away. Now, what if I told you this is where generative artificial intelligence comes in? It is a software that learns from you to produce content for you. Now, will it help you stay in the flow, or will it be a distraction? Now let's go back to flow. That magical state where ideas comes like a flood and your hours just fades away. I'm a writer and I write a lot of web articles and I experience this flow regularly. But more often than not, a sentence would trip me up. Have you experienced something similar? When you can't find the words and your ideas starts to fade away. Well, this time, instead of stopping my flow and finding the right sentence, I turn to my AI assistant. I punch in a few words, waited a few seconds, and it gave me a list of sentence options to pick from. I scanned through them, I selected the one I like, copied and pasted into the article, and just like that, I was back in the flow. And that's when I actually realized AI is really great at solving these small, detail-oriented tasks. And with AI managing these small distractions, I could really focus on the creative process and dive deep into what I'm doing. Apart from flow, there's another state that we designers call idea fixation. It is when you're stuck circling around the same idea and you just can't find a way forward. And it's like a trap. In a mental loop, and it's a creativity killer. So I experienced this fixation not too long ago when I had to make complex data not just understandable, but emotionally resonant, as well as in a form of a compelling story. I'm not a story writer, so I actually struggled a lot in this activity. But then I thought, what if I asked AI to help me out? I punched in the data, prompted it with a few storytelling techniques, and just like that, it created a list of story openings that, well, I didn't really want any of them. But one of them was just enough to trigger an idea in my head. And just like that, I found a way through. So what AI actually really did was, AI was like that friend that always thinks outside the box. And in my case, AI saw the box that I built around myself, opened the door, and set me free. And by throwing ideas that may sound odd at first, sometimes one of them might just be what you need to nudge you out of this fixed idea. Now, here's a third thing. How you define a problem often dictates how you solve it. And many a times, we get stuck in one approach that we often can't see the multiple ways to tackle the challenge. So not too long ago, I was working on an urban design project. And in this urban design project, one of my ideas was to use state-of-the-art technology in terms of sensors to measure and monitor the environment of a neighborhood. Well, this idea was not new. It's predictable. And quite frankly, I wanted something a bit more innovative. So I asked my AI companion, hey AI, how can we learn, or how can we know that our environments are healthy? Its response, introduce bees into the air and clams into the river. Bees and clams? I was like, what is going on? And then something clicked. Bees are natural indicators of good air quality, whereas clams are natural detectors of water toxicity. So what AI actually taught me was that knowing and measuring doesn't have to be technological. It could be biological. And by reframing the challenge for me, I found new creative ideas. When we let AI reframe the challenge for us, what it often does, it unlocks new solutions that we may not have arrived on our own. And I think this is where the partnership between human creativity and artificial intelligence gets truly exciting. Today, we are at the new era of creativity, where humans and AI collaborate as creative partners. So picture this. You're watching a movie, and towards the end, you're left wondering about the side character's story. Now, AI can actually generate alternate story endings for you to explore based on your imagination of this character. By prompting AI with a few keywords, it can take your idea and turn it into a video, a short film, for you to watch. And what it does is it expands the original story beyond something new. And it is this new realm of creativity that's so exciting. The partnership between human intuition and machine innovation. And I think this is where the exciting part really is. But it really isn't a one-way street. You know, when we work with AI, we are also shaping how it evolves for us. AI creates, but AI is not creative. What AI does is it enhances our creativity. It can take us through the flow, it can break us out of fixation, and it can really reframe problems to help us find new ways and new solutions. So where does this partnership with AI take us? You know, what creative untapped potential can we actually reach if we were to just say, you know, we lean in to collaborate with AI? And I think this is where the journey is fun. The journey of co-creativity with AI, where we can find our inner child creativity and rediscover it all over again, and this time with AI by our side. Thank you.